Hi everyone. So I'm back with another Disney-inspired tutorial, this time for Snow White, which is actually the first movie I ever saw in the theater. I was very scared of it, because that is a scary movie. But I'm gonna do Snow White. You know, she's not my favorite heroine princess, because she doesn't really do much except for not follow like common sense instructions and then dies and then just gets saved magically. So not a super fan of hers, but also she has that annoying voice. I mean, you know. But whatever. She can rock the primary colors, and so we're gonna do that today. So I am gonna start with trying to create a nice light base because she's got skin as white as snow. So gross. So let's see what I can do to extra make myself light. As if I really need that much help doing that. Okay, let's get started. So I'm gonna try this Silky Fit Concealer BB. That looks pretty light. And I'm gonna put this all over. Has that lightened me? Yeah, I think it has. And if that wasn't enough, we're gonna go in with some more concealer. I'm gonna be using my Kat Von D concealer that I love so much. It's very thick. So I don't know if everybody would love this, but I'm gonna actually pull it down a little more to extra brighten. Can you hear my puppy walking around? Good girl. Lie down. Minimize some of my redness. I hope you find puppy claws on the floor soothing. Okay. Now I'm going to be using my Maybelline Fit, and I'm going to use this powder instead of my Bare Essentials because it's definitely lighter. You can see my hair is wet, but I am gonna be wearing a wig in this at the end, so it's okay. All right, well that has done a good job of lightening my skin. I thought I would try use a beauty blender for this, some of this blush serum. She doesn't really have very rosy cheeks, but I'm not trying to look exactly like her. wanted to do like a inspired by look. So I'm gonna, I feel like this is, Disney princesses are a time to use this pinky blush serum. Just high up and in the apples of my cheeks to make me look like a princess. Okay, and then I'm gonna take this milk makeup and go over top in my highlight area. It smells like Play-Doh. Like, for real and for true. It smells like Play-Doh. And now I'm just gonna give that a good tap in. Lots of highlighter. And I'm gonna use my favorite highlighter brush, which is from Ulta. It brushes, it's just a flat, pretty stiff brush, and I think it's great for highlighting. And I'm going to be using this City Color highlighter trio, which I think is pretty cheap from a drugstore. I'm using the two lighter colors. I'm so shiny. Okay. All right. Next, let's put on a little bit of eyeshadow primer. This is just my Urban Decay. I have the anti-aging one because I am, in fact, aging. All right, then I feel like I need a little bit of contour. What do you think? Yes. Let's see if this Pixie by Petra color is dark enough. Now I'm gonna just dip back and sort of blend in. Blend out. Blend in and blend out. That's a little better. Gives my face some dimension. Okay. All right, the first thing I'm gonna do is start with yellow. Because, right? I said she rocks a primary color. So I'm going to be using this palette for the whole thing. Except not the pink, for the yellow and blue. I'm going to go into my eye crease with this yellow. I like this yellow because it's a little bit more, I'm going to use a darker yellow as well, but this one is very, you know, paler. I can't talk today. Paler yellow. So you see, I'm not trying to look like her because she definitely doesn't wear yellow eyeshadow. And that's why I didn't want to do like looking like the princesses, because they just don't wear that much makeup. Only the villain women do, because apparently only bad people and old people wear makeup. But I just thought it would be fun to sort of try to bring in their like signature colors and features. So that's the plan, Stan. Okay. So now I have yellow. You want to watch Fallout with yellow because it will make you look jaundiced. Nobody wants to look jaundiced. Now I'm going to be going in with this Makeup Forever in the color don't know, in yellow. Okay. I want to use a more precise brush for this. Let's see, where's a brush that would be good for this? Those are not precise. Here we go. I found one. This is a nice small brush by Bare Minerals for contour shadow. And then I'm gonna go into the yellow. And then I'm gonna kind of rub it around in the lid. Really want to avoid fallout. And you want to bring the yellow down onto the bottom lid. Getting it in the crease there. You want to get that closed, believe me. Then I'm going to go back in with the paler yellow just to blend out. Blend out, no. And make sure that it looks nice. To just take a little bit of concealer or some liquid lipstick, liquid eyeshadow or liner or something, and just go into the inner corners with it. Oh, that's too much. Well, I'll just dab it, dab it, and tap it, tap it, tap it with the beauty blender. This is kind of a technique I've been using a lot lately. I don't want to have goops, but. And then I'll take this actual sponge and the yellow. Because this is a pretty yellow. See, that really brightens it up in there. You can go right down into your inner corners. And that's very pretty. Very pretty. All right, so that's for that. The next thing I'm going to do is the Wet n Wild Mega Liner that I have in this royal blue. It's called Voltage Blue or Bleu Tension. And here we go. nice thick line. Okay. Yeah. I mean, this is kind of a harder look to pull off every day. Because we all remember the words of the fashion club from Daria, mixing primary colors in daylight, not done. Immortal words, that's the word I was looking for. I believe that Sandy said that. And if you don't know Daria, just go watch a couple episodes right now. Feel like this one's thicker or thinner. Now I feel like it extends a little further. Then I'm gonna take a small little pencil brush and go into this blue and do my under eyes. You can see I did get a little bit of fallout under there. I'm gonna need to clean that up because that doesn't look good. Okay. Now I need to do my brows, and I'm gonna use this palette because I'm gonna try to get them a little darker than normal. I'm gonna use my regular brush and try this metal color. I don't want to go right to black because that's pretty dark. Oh, I clumped it up in the middle there. This is not expensive brow powder. It's a good brush, but it's LA Colors brow. Right, I'm gonna take it a step darker and go in with the black. Just over top of what I already did, so it's not so stark. I'm going to do lashes today. This is exciting because I don't usually do lashes, but I will do them. Because I think this look needs them. So I'm gonna just use, and I'm sorry, I don't remember which lashes these are from. But I'm just gonna, this is my very scientific way of getting glue on my lashes. Kind of rubbing them like that. Don't eat our books. My dog is like being bad lately. She's like eating our things, like our books and records. And I just bought a set of DVDs. You can't take that outside. Okay, she didn't. All right, now let's see if I can do this. Messed up on that one. Oh. Well, that was a mess. And now I have glue everywhere. I've noticed that some makeup gurus put their lashes on off camera. Fix that in a minute after this dries. Just coming off? Yes, it's coming off. Okay, these went on better. I really want to try the magnetic kind. You can't put a tweezer in your eye. Okay, let me just go in here and fix this. Well, I messed it up a little, but you know, it's not gonna be perfect. Now, of course, we're gonna go in with a red lip. Okay. And then, because what is her signature but an apple, we're gonna get in there with an apple. Let that dry for a minute. Make sure these are on. And then I can go in with mascara. And then I will go in with just a black little liner. And now time for the wig. You're not really supposed to probably put a wig on over wet hair, but I'm not gonna have it on for a long time. So this is a long wig that I used for my Queen of the Damned look last Halloween. I don't have a red ribbon, but I figured this is close enough. This is just a little scarf I have. Oh, come on. There we go. Okay, so there's Snow White. I hope that you have enjoyed this. Let me know if there are other princesses you'd like to see. I have already done Elsa. I did her a while ago, but it was more of a trying to look like her instead of inspired by, and I don't love it, so maybe I'm gonna redo that one. I wish these lashes would stay on. And in the meantime, I will think of the next thing. All right. I'll see you next time. Bye.